The new coffee maker arrives. So this is the Orbegozo MO3400 200 watt burr coffee grinder. And I don't even need the knife for this one because apparently it was shipped without even doing it up. Device has resettable fuse protection system that acts on overheating. When the fuse works, activity stops. The device must cool down for about 30 minutes. Ensure the device is clean of grinds from blocking it. Yeah. Okay. So the box actually feels pretty good weight to it. I mean, I've had the Breville Smart Grinder Pro. Pretty weighty, decent. Probably about the same as this weight, actually. Very similar formats and size. Actually, this top lid looks almost the same as the Breville's. And I also had the Bodum mill grinder, what do you call that one? The burr grinder with the glass craft, not the cheaper plastic one. But that one actually was a fair bit lighter weight, a little bit lower quality feeling than the Breville. I mean, it's like half the price of the Breville Smart Grinder Pro 2, but... So this was actually on sale on one of the random electronic sites in Portugal on the website that had it for, I think it was 37 euros and then just a few euros for shipping, so it's pretty good. Took about a week to get here. Let's get this all unpackaged. So it is a Euro EU plug, 220 to 240 volts. Sorry, lid. Gets everything out of the box. Nice little picture. Lid. I mean, it is just ABS plastic. A little, actually, it's pretty nice quality. It's actually the little popcorn stopper is actually screwed on. Decent weight plastic. Feels good. Does actually have a... No, it doesn't. It feels like it has a rubber seal, like the Breville does, but it doesn't. It's just the plastic molding to compress as it goes on. And there's the main deal right there. Nice and black. Two-prong cord. Really thin cord. Oh, nice, kind of clicks into place. Again, lighter than the Breville. But I mean, like, this is a fraction of the price of a Smart Grinder Pro. ABS plastic, no rubber sealing or screwing on, it's just to push together. The grind chute. Nice and clicky. Overall, it feels like a good quality to it. It's got a cord wrap built in, so that's nice. No clicking on, this is the timer setting. It's a metal looking plastic. And I believe it does actually have an LED that glows blue when it's on or off. So it looks like also the hopper has to... has to lock into place. Yeah. Nice looking machine. And then this also, this should be the burr.
Yeah.
So this is actually interesting. I wasn't sure because the photos didn't show it, but the, I saw somebody mention about it being a flat burr, and it is a flat burr. That's kind of cool. Normally you get a, what do you call it? The cone burr or the, oh, and it's actually got a metal grind deflector in there too. So I know on the Smart Grinder Pro, that's one of the weaknesses, is actually that it's got like the little impeller that shoots the ground coffee down the chute, but it's made of like, sort of has metal edges and plastic in there, and it's kind of a weak spot. So that's kind of cool. This whole carrier is really cheap plastic, but it's actually proper, I don't know if that's ceramic, maybe dark ceramic, or is it just metal? But yeah, it's a small flat burr. Three screws here. It looks like there should be a way to undo. Yeah, there's one bolt to remove the lower burr. Looks like to get to the impeller, you'd actually have to take the machine apart halfway through. But hopefully, we don't have to do that ever. But yeah, good little machine looking. 200 watts. I think it says it holds 240 gram, so it's like a little over half pound of coffee up top. And you can hear it's got a click, so when the hopper is on, it activates the machine. Yes, there you go. Quick little unboxing. We'll do a usage review in a minute. Thank you. Right, well, try to ignore the sound of that little leaf blower or trimmer, whatever that is, because right now we've got an Amazon warehouse deal that we picked up. That might actually be a scooter. I thought it was a leaf blower. Some of the mopeds are so small here. So we've been using French press. I have an ESPRESSO French press tumbler as well. And then we got a mocha pot. At the other place we were staying, we had a, what do you call it? Delta Q machine to make coffee with espresso in it. And it was just, it's just so painful after coming from an actually good espresso machine to try to use those machines all the time with pods and capsules and I don't get grinders or buying pre-ground coffee for the mocha pot. And then Elaine got me a little hand grinder for the mocha pot for Christmas to just get us by a little bit. And yeah, that's been burning up our arms in the morning, so we're kind of like, hey, let's just jump in and get an espresso machine. So anyways, this is a GAGGIA VIVA Deluxe. Now this I think ranges from like 140 to 170 on retail sites. And on Amazon I think it's listed like 140-ish. But we got this from the warehouse platform of deals, and this one was literally listed as a very good condition return, and the only blemishes it had listed was small blemish, as in like half a centimeter or less on the back and bottom of the machine, so it's like, well, you're not even gonna see that. So yeah, hence we went for the deal. Anyways, I'm gonna hope this box doesn't fall off and my camera flies everywhere. It's quieter now at least, so that's cool. But yeah, the box came a little haggard. It only took a few days to get here, but man, one side just split open. The listing did say that it doesn't have the original packaging, which is fine, I don't really care about that. So what they've done is they've wrapped it all in bubble. All the bits and bobs are just right in the middle. They did send the manual, Gaggia Milano, for the Gaggia Viva style, chic, deluxe, or prestige. So yeah, fat manual. Doesn't have any thumbprints on it, so maybe it wasn't even used, I don't know. And yeah, it's got a good little weight to it for a tiny machine. Kind of like the initial vibe of how much it weighs. So between the different versions of this machine, there's the style, chic, and deluxe, and what was the other one? Prestige. And basically those only have varying levels of metal cladding. So this one being the mid-range one, it actually has like the stainless face, and it's got the metal cup holder, cup tray on top for warming tray. The bottom range one actually just has plastic everything, so plastic drip tray, plastic front, plastic top, plastic steam wand. This one has some of those things as metal. And then the higher end one, the Prestige, is basically all metal design on the outside, metal cladding. Let's get this thing unwrapped and take a peek. See if they lied to me. Portafilter has definitely not been used. Which is nice because I was under the impression from the listing that it was a new return product, which it appears to be. So it's got one basket in there right now. It's pretty cool too, so Gaggia went with this method of using a proper basket and pressurizing the handle instead of the basket. Whereas a lot of other makers have gone with the fully pressurized basket, which means you either have to buy unpressurized ones or use one that comes with it. It is a flimsy handle, like it is plastic and tinny. It's got the spring loading mechanism for when you're tightening it on, so you don't tighten it too much, but yeah, it's all brand new. No debris, no use, no marks. Get this puppy out of here. Just want to take the bits out so it's actually not gonna break anymore. Yeah, so this has all been unpackaged. I mean, there's a few scrapes on here, but I think that's just from this sliding metal drip tray instead of, or metal grate on the plastic drip tray. So that's great. Looks awesome, actually. It looks really good. There's a few fingerprints that might just be from me, like right now, though. Gaggia Viva Deluxe. The decals all look good. Unused, definitely. There's a little bit of scraping along this, but again, I think that's just from the packaging method where they had the metal grate floating in there. If that was bubble wrapped, there wouldn't be any scratches there, but they're very minuscule, and it's like, it's not even a place where you can see. And yeah, there's like a little bit of a scrape along the back, not much, like you can hardly see. I don't even know why they said there's a scrape on the bottom. There's no noticeable damage on the bottom. So yeah, it shows a GAGGIA R1-8435-11. Should be the code for this model, the Viva Deluxe. So 230 volt, 50 hertz, and it's 1,025 watts. Perfect. Manufactured 2021. So it's got this lift off here for the tank cover, I guess. Coffee scoop and tamp all in one right here. Now I have ordered a tamp that will come. That's got a fairly hefty gap. 2.5, 2 millimeters gap, so that's not really gonna give you a lot of pressure. Interesting, they gave me this one too. I think this is actually for ESE pods. That one. Cool. This little holder for the portafilter, basket filters there. Removable drip tray. That's handy. We'll slide it out. Not a big capacity, but I mean, it's not a big machine. It's, you gotta sacrifice some things. It's got a drip stop there. Spring release. Very cool. This thing just needs a little wash down and... Oh, that's why that was it. Oh, cool. This just kind of sits, doesn't really do anything. Now I have read some people saying that we need to do some things to get this running well for the first go, because obviously the new machine, it has to prime itself, but we'll read the instructions and get that all done. Alright, so here's both new items unboxed. There's the new GAGGIA Viva Deluxe. And my Orbegozo flat burr grinder. So all I've done so far is just taken off all the bean contact areas. So the hopper, the grind catch, the removable burr. And then on this one I did the tamper and scoop and the portafilter with the filter, the drip tray, gave everything a nice wipe down, filled up the water tank, washed out the water tank. Now I haven't plugged in the GAGGIA yet because there is a priming sequence that you're supposed to make sure is done properly the first time, so that's what that thing right there says. And yeah, I just put some beans into the hopper of this Orbegozo. So I've only set it to like about a between coarse and medium because I like my French press to not be crazy coarse. And I just put it on a 2-cup setting here. Just to do like a little test French press from it. Probably not the best thing to like drink the first one out of the grinder, but hey, why not? I need some coffee, so let's give it a go. It's going to be a little bit loud. I've ran it just a little bit previous, so it is loud. Here you go. Some dust going on there. Cool. Good to know. About proximity of things. Let's see, what does that look like in there? Let's see here. That's not a bad grind for French press, actually. It's some chunkiness, not overly chunky, maybe 1.5 millimeter at biggest.
Fair bit of fines right now, but I mean, this burr's never been used. Doesn't look overly staticky, which is good. Alright. Gonna make up a little French press with that. So what it actually says is priming the circuit. Place a container under the Panarello with the selection knob at the central standby position. So that would be standby position is up, as in off. Let's get a cup. Fancy. Now, insert the plug into the wall power socket and set the power button on I to switch the machine on. Okay. Well, let's make sure first that it's in the off position. Yes, it is off. So, let's put this, oh, just to verify to you. Can see here I have filled, maybe not all the way to max because it's just gonna spill if I do that, but yeah, relatively full. Make sure it's pushed all the way down. So let's plug this in. Insert the plug, the power light with the to switch machine on. So essentially what it says is after inserting the socket, put it onto the I position on the back, power light will come on. Turn the selector knob up to the coffee position. Hot water will flow out of the Panarello. Oh yeah, so we're supposed to open this. Turn the hot water steam knob counterclockwise. Yeah, so it's open. Yeah. So we're gonna turn it on and then put it onto coffee mode. Water should come into the coffee mug below. I wish I was able to show you better. But I have a smaller cup. I'm gonna do this one. Okay. Let's do this. Once the water tank is empty, move the selection knob back to central standby position. Turn the hot water steam knob clockwise, remove the container. So basically, it didn't blatantly say it, but it actually wants me to empty the tank once. Okay. And I guess that's just to rinse out the inside of the machine. So I switched it on at the back. And you can see the power knob came on. This is open from closed. This is closed. This is open. And we're going to go into coffee mode. Is put a bigger container under there. Yeah. think that should be pretty good. All primed up, and then I'm going to run some water through the steam wand. Okay, so now that the machine has been primed, I refilled the tank. The coffee light is on. So now I'm just going to run some water through the the portafilter. Get that thing all rinsed out. Okay. So, cup underneath. And we're just going to go make sure this is locked up so it's not going to shoot out the steam wand. Let me go to the right. So now that we've done the rinsing, the next step will be just grinding a bunch of espresso grind and maybe pulling like 3 to 4 shots of espresso just to get coffee through the system and kind of take out that plastic and machine and any manufacturing oils kind of taste. From what I heard before, somebody commented saying that I think GAGGIA in their factories actually do run coffee through the machines before sending, which makes sense because it looks to me like there is a little bit of a tinge to the water, like there may be just the tiniest residue. So yeah, hopefully a couple of wasted shots is not a big deal and we can get some good coffee after that. Okay, coffee's ground, portafilter's on, let's see how this first coffee goes. Dark color crema, pretty good. You can see the nice differentiation in the colors there. Have to give it a taste. That's the stuff I've been missing.